Hello and welcome to the channel. In this video I will be looking at various battery options. When I was looking at this, I actually came across this interesting chemistry called LTO. LTO is lithium titanate oxide, and it's absolutely amazing in comparison to other options such as LFP, lithium iron phosphate, and common options such as NMC, nickel, manganese, cobalt. I'm building my testing modules. However, this is not the modules I'll be using in the car. I will be looking at other options, purchasing some second-hand batteries from eBay. But also, the problem with eBay, you can never know what seller you can trust. And batteries could be in very bad state, and you can spend quite a bit of money and get something that is completely knackered and not really useful for your conversion. So one of the other things I was looking at various sellers on AliExpress and Alibaba, and of course you will say, well, how can you trust those as well? Because lots of Chinese suppliers are known to supply batteries that are not really fulfilling their characteristics that specify on the spec sheet. Yes, that's true, and this is another problem. So I actually found a company in Europe that is supplying, obviously, batteries from China, but they do verify them and they do test them. The special thing about LTO, it has incredible power density. It can be charged and discharged at very high rate, such as 6C or 10C. So I'll remind you, to C, it's a basically capacity of the battery. So if we have 1 amp hour cell, so 6C means we can charge or discharge it at 6 amp. Or let's say if we go for 10C, it will be 10 amp. So if you imagine you have 94 amp hour battery, so you can actually charge it and discharge it at 940 amps. This would be absolutely incredible. Of course, there is always a downside. The downside to this is that this chemistry has very low energy density. So roughly this chemistry would give you sort of 40 amp hours on a similar size and the weight cell that you can get, for example, for normal 94 amp hours chemistry. Let's have a look at one of the chemistries that used in electric cars. So this is not the best. This is Samsung SDI, and this one is used in cars like BMW i3. Let's look at the characteristics of the cell. So you will notice that the discharge is quoted at temperatures such as 25 degrees C. It's about 345 watt hours for this cell. So energy density is 165 watt hours per kilogram. So this is all great. And also interesting factor is the life cycle. So with a depth of discharge 70%, we're expecting a life cycle of 5,200. Okay, and that's with a charge rate of 0.5 C to 1 C. So if we look at the Tesla cells, without going into too much details, one of the things I wanted to highlight, the Tesla 18650 cells, energy density is about 250 watt hours per kilogram. So now they move to 21700 cells and they have energy density 300 watt hours per kilogram. So if we look at the LFP, lithium iron phosphate, they have much less nominal voltage. Nominal voltage is 3.2 volts. But what's interesting, looking in this cell, we have much higher discharge rate. If we look at the nominal energy density, 140 watt hours per kilogram. So as you could see, much less than Tesla, for example. But one of the benefits of the LFP cells is that with the depth of discharge 80%, we are having expectation that it will last about 3000 cycles. So as we can see here, the LFP gives us much better life cycle. Its power density is not great. So if we look at the Tesla, best it's 300. So it's almost twice as high. But also you can see that the discharge and charge rate for this chemistry is also higher in comparison with the NMC, nickel, manganese, cobalt. And the other interesting factor, you cannot charge this battery below 0 degrees Celsius, but although you can discharge at minus 20. But now let's have a look at LTO chemistry. As you can see, one of the notable differences is that the nominal voltage is 2.3 volts. So if we look at the LFP, nominal voltage is
3.2. So nominal voltage for an NMC chemistry is 3.68 volts here, but it can be charged up to 4.2. But what's amazing about this chemistry, it has amazing power density. So maximum discharge current, it does allow 10C discharge current. So this is something that none of these other batteries will give you in terms of the discharge. So this cell with 45 amp hour capacity can be discharged at 450 amps. So this is kind of like moving close to super capacitor territory. And operating temperature is minus 45 to 65 degrees C. So if you remember on other tech sheet, I mentioned that those chemistries cannot be charged below 0 degrees. So this one can be charged at minus 45. So that means that before charging, there is no need to warm up the battery. Because for example, Tesla does warm up the battery before you plug in your charger. They even have a feature in the software. When you drive to supercharger, it automatically starts preheating the battery. And also the other amazing thing that it can be discharged at the same minus 45 degrees C.
Lithium titanate technology is based on modified lithium-ion batteries, and it employs additional lithium titanate nanocrystals on the surface of its anode, instead of the conventional carbon that is used in normal lithium-ion batteries. This gives anode surface area of 100 square meters per gram, which is significantly more when compared to 3 square meters per gram achieved using conventional carbon material, allowing electrons to enter and leave the anode far more quickly. Because of this large surface, recharging the LTO battery is also very quick. The improvements in the surface area of the battery drastically increases the LTO cell's general stability and further improves LTO technology safety. Because of the benefits of lithium titanate in terms of high security, high stability, and long life, the green features lithium titanate batteries can be widely used in electric vehicles and charging stations. The downside is very low energy density, but I'm thinking that it may be possible to try to make hybrid battery with the combined LTO cells, for example, and maybe LFP cells. So LFP cells would be working as storage container, and LTO cells could be working as kind of a fast charge recharge battery, which will allow you to capture more regen and at the same time charge car in much faster time, and use this as a buffer to smooth out acceleration demand for current, and also to have a quick charge where this will quickly store smaller amount of charge but will allow you for a very quick charging.